like to start with a short story from my childhood. So when I was 8 years old, I was in the hospital for several months fighting a bacterial disease. At that time, any of the antibiotic which was present on the market could not help for the problem which I had. Luckily, the clinical trials of new antibiotic was going on, and I could take part in this, and it helped. So that was the moment when a faith of, like, my future faith was kind of made. So that was the moment when I decided to go into science. So my name is Agata Starosta, and today I would like to tell you more about my research. So as we know, nowadays, the access to all means of transportation is greater than ever before. So within several hours, we can be in different city, different country, or even different continent. And so can bacteria. As you may be aware or not, we have bacteria on every surface of our body, on every surface we ever touch. So all furniture, all places in underground, and less everywhere. So as you may be aware or not, we can divide bacteria to healthy ones and unhealthy, and pathogens. So the healthy bacteria, they actually account for 3% of our body mass. They are very important for metabolism. For example, when we eat vegetables, they help us to digest cellulose. They prevent allergies, and they are very important for immunity. So if, as a mother or father, you try to prevent your kid from germs, you're actually not doing this kid much of the favor. And so the other bacteria are the pathogenic ones. So these are the ones which try to invade our body, and they cause many several diseases. So for example, tuberculosis, deadly meningitis, or tetanus. So the traditional antibiotics, they target basic bacteria function, which means they try to kill them. But you don't discriminate the healthy ones from the pathogenic ones, which increases the side effects of the antibiotical therapy. So which it also increases the problem of multi-drug resistance bacteria, since they can communicate and get the new ways how to deal, how to fight against those antibiotics. So in my research, I decided to take a new approach. So instead of targeting the general functions of bacteria, I would like to target the means which makes bacteria pathogenic. So instead of killing them, I would like to not allow them to colonize our body, or by making them not motile, or to prevent them for like injecting virulence factors. So what you can see, so here we have a scheme of bacteria. So they have many mechanisms like flagella or pili, which allow them to migrate in our body and attach to our cells. Moreover, they have something which is called secretion system, which is needle-like mechanism, which injects virulence factors to our cells, and those factors, they actually make us sick. So I identified the protein which is called elongation factor P, which actually turned out to be a major regulator of virulence in bacteria. Moreover, this protein is present in all bacteria, but, which is good for us, it differs between species, which makes it a unique target for new antibiotics. So in this, once we try to target the specific protein instead of general functions of bacteria, we can design antibiotics which are specific and they are not targeting the healthy ones. I think as we are here and you're the insurance company, so the important points of this would be that this kind of antibiotic therapy will shorten hospitalization periods, will decrease side effects, and will allow faster recovery time, and hopefully will bring cure for deadly infections. So even if you are, if you were not affected personally by severe bacterial infections, maybe one day, although I don't wish anyone, your child, somebody in your family, your friend will be affected. And as my parents were very happy, and I was very happy when I was a child that there was a cure, so I really hope that my research will bring the same happiness for the families in the future. So I would like to thank you for your attention. I will be very happy to take questions.
You started your talk saying that multi-resistance of bacteria to antibiotics is more and more of a problem. How this method would help in this regard?
This is completely new place where you would like to like design antibiotics for. So bacteria don't know those antibiotics, so they will need some time to actually evolve new mechanism. Yes. That means, I mean, even if other antibiotics are not effective, you'll have something that bacteria don't know. Because I mean, this is like bacteria is like, I mean, like humans, like the learning process.